Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to our 12th lecture on body plots. So earlier we have been discussing on the frequency response analysis, as well as we have just started to sketch the body plot. As we all of us know that the body plot is actually a combination of two plots, the magnetic plot and the phase plot. So there are two plots under the body plot. One is the magnetic plot and another is the phase plot. And the common things between both the plot is the frequency. So magnitude versus frequency is magnitude plot, and phase versus frequency is phase plot. Note down the units. The magnitude units is in decibel. The frequency, it is in log of omega. The phase in degree, frequency again it is in log of omega, the base is 10. This is what we have discussed. We have also discussed the features of the semilog graph paper, which has a cycle or a decay. So the body plot is drawn on semilog graph paper. I hope all of you might downloaded the semilog graph paper, the sample of that, and just seen the how it is, how the cycles are created, okay, and how it is non-linear plot. All right, I have forget my duster to. So understanding the graphs and the structure of the graph and semilog graph paper, and understanding the meaning of frequency response, understanding what are the axis labeling and their units. Now let's start on the creating the body plot. So we might have given this G of S, H of S, the open transfer function that is given to you. Now here, so S is replaced by J omega. Okay. We have seen why the real part is not included in this frequency response. So the first step is that you make G of S as G of J omega and H of J omega. This is the first step. And the second step is convert the open loop transfer function in time constant form. Okay, so I need to convert G of S, H of S into its time constant form. So right now, I think there should not be any problem. You can have the step 2 as 1, and then later you can replace S by J omega also, okay, vice versa. So replacing S by J omega is actually not a difficult task. Let us understand this task. That is, convert the open loop transfer function G of S, H of S into its time constant form. Before that, so we know that any transfer function can have, so I'm discussing transfer function terms, can have different terms. So can have first order term, So a first order term, it would be something like this. This is a first order term. It can have second order term like this. This is the second order term, complex number. It can have the first order term in the numerator. This is in the first order term in denominator. Okay, this is also in denominator, but it can have first order term, let's say s plus 4. So the first order term, it is in numerator. Similarly, the second order term can be also in the numerator. Okay, it can have a pole at origin, 1 by s. This is also a one term. It can have 0 at origin on the numerator side. Okay, so these are the different terms involved in the open-loop transfer functions. See, in open-loop transfer function, if there, it is a third order term, if it is a third order polynomial in S, then you can always categorize into the three first order terms, or it can have one first order term and one second order term. So I can always find the roots to get first order terms and second order terms. Right now we are in the topic of converting the transfer function into time constant form. Okay. Alright. So let's say you have been given 1 upon 3s plus 6. Now this is not a time constant form. Okay. The time constant form is 1 upon tau s plus 1. This is the time constant form. Let's say 3s plus, not 6, but you can say 5, okay? So I need to convert this into a time constant form. So time constant form means this s raised to 0 term, it has a coefficient 1. So s raised to 0 should have a coefficient, 1. So what I can do, I can take 5 common. Okay, so 1 upon 5 is common, so you can say 3 by 5 s plus 1. So now it is 1 by 5 upon k upon tau s plus 1. So 3 by 5 s plus 1, this is into a time constant form. In this, this is the steady state gain k, this is my tau, so tau s plus 1. So tau s plus 1 is known as the time constant form. So this is how a first order term can be converted into its time constant form. Okay. So what about this 1 by s? So you can say you cannot convert into a time constant form, okay, because a pole at origin or a zero at origin cannot be converted into its time constant form. The standard time constant form is k upon tau s plus 1. You need to convert your transfer function if there is a first order term in the denominator or in the numerator, you need to convert into a k upon tau s plus 1. Now let's say there is a first order term at let's say 4s plus 2 in the numerator side. Okay, then how you can, this should be 1. Okay, so I will have 2 common, so 4 by 2 s, okay, plus 1. So this is nothing but 2, this is 2, okay, so this is 2. Yeah, so you have converted 2 into 2 s plus 1. This is a time constant form. You have separated the gain, okay, and this is in the tau s plus s form. Let us take one more example. Let's say s plus 5, 1 upon, let's say s plus 6. This is not in the time constant form. So to convert into a time constant form, I need to have 6 common, s by 6 plus 1. So this is 1 by 6 upon s by 6 plus 1. So now what is this is k, what is tau? Tau is 1 by 6. Okay, So tau s plus 1. This is how you convert any first order term in the numerator or in the denominator of the open transfer function into its time constant form. Now let us convert a second order term into its time constant form. So you might be aware that the second order term is represented like this. Okay. So this is s raised to 0, this is s raised to 1, and this is s raised to 0. This is s raised to 2, this is s raised to 1, this is s raised to 0. So the coefficient of s raised to 2 is 1, the coefficient of s raised to 1 is 2 xi omega n, coefficient of s raised to 0 is omega n square. Now you, this is not in time constant form, okay, this is not in time constant form. So I need to convert this term into a time constant form. Time constant form means coefficient of s raised to 0 should be 1. Okay, this is required. Alright, so let's say one upon s square plus 2s plus 9. So s raised to 0 coefficient is 1, s raised to 1 coefficient is 2, s raised to 0 the coefficient is 9. So I need to convert into a time constant form. Okay, so how I can do? I can do like this, 1 upon, I can take 9 common, okay, this is s squared by 9 plus 2 by plus 1. So this is 1 by 9, okay, upon s squared. So this is s by 3 whole square plus 2 by 9 s plus 1. This is in time constant form. Okay. So in general, s square plus 2 xi omega ns plus omega n square, this term can be converted into a time constant via taking omega n square common. Okay, so this is s square by omega n square plus 2 xi, okay, by omega n s plus 1. This is how this can be converted into a time constant form. You need to have the coefficient of s raised to 0 to be 1. This is how the system is converted into a time constant form, second order term. Alright. Now let us take one example. Let's say 3 upon s plus 4 into s plus 6. This is the transfer function. I need to convert this transfer function into its time constant form. And it, right now it is not in the time constant form. Okay, so what can I do? 3 upon, I will take 4 common to get s by 4 plus 1. I will take 6 common to get 1 s by 6 plus 1. So this is nothing but 3 upon 24 s by 4 plus 1 s by 6 plus 1. Okay, this is nothing but 3 by 24 divided by s by 4 plus 1 s by 6 plus 1. So this is the steady state gain k. Okay, and this is required, okay, in our in sketching the border plot. So the finding the true value of the steady state gain k 3 by 24 after converting into a time constant form, this is very crucial, because our starting point of the border plot will be from finding the steady state gain k. So if you find the steady state gain k wrongly, then your entire border plot is wrong. So this is very important. So now this transfer function is written in the time constant form, where this term 3 by 24 is the steady state gain k. Alright. So finding this term is very important, the gain K. Okay. All right. Let us check one more example. Let's say like this. So this is the transfer function. Well, 3 is the gain, s plus 6 into s plus 2 into s square plus 4s plus 18. Now here, you can see how many terms are there in a transfer function. This is one numerator term, first order term. This is one first order term, a pole at origin. This is a first order term in the denominator. This is a second order term. Okay. If this second order terms, see, you need to factorize this. If you get real roots, then you need to expand this. But if the roots are complex conjugate, then you need to keep it as a second order term. Okay. So now, I repeat, this is a second order term. But if you can able to find the real roots, then you need to expand into two first order terms. If you cannot find the real roots, if there are complex conjugate roots, then you can keep it as like this. Now I need to convert into its time constant form. So now what can I do? 3 is already there. I'm taking 6 common, so this is s by 6 plus 1. Okay, now s is keeping s like this, s into, I'm taking 2 common, so what is this now, s by 2 plus 1. Okay, now I'm taking 18 common on this term, so you will get s square by 18 plus 4s by 18 plus 1. Okay, so now what is this? 3 into 6, it is 18 into s by 6 plus 1. Okay. Then 2 into 18 is nothing but 36. Okay. Then s by 2 plus 1. Okay. Into s square by 18 plus 4 by 8 is 2 by 9 s plus 1. Okay. So this is nothing. Now you put this 36 on the numerator. So 18 by 36 is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, or you can say 0.5. 0.5 s by 6 plus 1 divided by, you can say s by 2 plus 1. You can say s square by 18 plus 2 by 9 s plus 1. This is in time constant form, okay? Now, whatever the gain that you are receiving, this constant term, this is known as steady state gain K. And this is required in the border plot. So, 0.5 is the steady state gain K. This is how you can convert into a time constant form. I hope it is clear to you. All right. Let us take one more example. Let's say is something like this. I'm assuming that both these are having the complex conjugate poles, okay? Alright. I need to convert into time constant form. So 0.2 common. Since this is s to 0 is not 1, I will take 100 common. So this is s squared by 100 plus 9 by 100 s plus 1. Okay. Then SQL, I will keep it as like this, 6 common, so test by 6 plus 1, okay. I will take, since SS to 0 in this term is not 1, coefficient of SS to 0 is not 1, I will take 10 common, then this is SQL by 10 plus 2 by 10 S plus 1, okay. So now, 0.2 into 100 is nothing but 20 into SQL by 100 plus 9 by 100 S plus 1 divided by, I will take 6 into 10 common, so 60 S square, then S by 6 plus 1, then S square by 10 plus 2 by 10 is 1 by 5 S plus 1. So 20 by 60, it is 1 by 3. So this is, I will put here 20 by 60. Okay, and this is nothing but 1 by 3. So this 1 by 3 is the steady state gain K. Okay. This is the steady state gain. Perfect. So we have learned two steps to sketch the border plot. The first step is convert your open loop transfer function g of s, h of s into its time constant form. For a first order system, first order term, the time constant form is tau s plus 1. For a second order term, if it is s square plus 2 xi omega ns plus omega n square like this, then the coefficient of s raised to 0, which is omega n square, you need to put it as 1. So you need to take omega n square common, make it on the left hand side. And then after converting into a time constant form, then you need to replace S by J omega in this system. So let us finish this lecture here only. And we'll, in the coming lecture, in the next lecture, we are going to learn from the step number 2. We'll move toward the step number 3, that is finding the corner frequencies from the open loop transfer functions. Okay, note that we need to sketch the two plots, the magnitude plot and the phase plot. The magnitude plot is the magnitude in decibel versus the frequency in logarithmic scale, that is log of W base 10. And in phase plot, we need to draw the phase versus frequency, the phase in the degrees and the frequency is in logarithmic scale, that is log of W. Thank you.